You know, Bharat Cultural Integration Committee used to organize very beautiful music programs in Puttaparthi just before Bhagwan's birthday. Many prominent singers from India, from abroad would come, and they would kind of, you know, get an opportunity to sing in front of Swami. I don't want to take a name, but he was one of the greatest exponents of Shastriya Sangeet, Hindustani. He had come to perform. I remember this vividly because that particular year, Prime Minister was Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who passed away recently. He was to come, and Bhagwan was waiting for him that particular evening. And this exponent of Hindustani Sangeet started his first alap, and Bhagwan was sitting there among the audience. And then, hardly he had gone through 1 or 2 minutes into the rendition, Bhagwan suddenly got up and he came up behind. Now, if you know about our Indian music, especially when the great ustads or exponents of Shastriya or Carnatic songs, when they kind of, you know, sit down to give a performance, it is considered an offense or an insult if you get up in between and walk out. And here was our Lord. 1 or 2 minutes after the alap, he had got up and he had come to the backstage. And we were there behind, and I was kind of, you know, worried whether something Swami wanted and we had not done. And that's why Swami had to kind of, you know, leave the music rendition in the middle. First song also is not complete, and then had to come back. And Swami just came back and he sat down, he called us, and he was just talking with us. The first song finished, and that exponent had about 1.5 hours of time. And all of a sudden, what do I hear? Shouting of that exponent. This is the first time, I'm the greatest singer of this world, and this is the first time someone has insulted me like this. I will never ever come back. And he just walked out. Fast forward a couple of years, Bhagwan started music college. There were little children who were learning. And one evening, Bhagwan tells me, call the music students to come, and I want to listen to them. Those music students came there. Swami Bhagwan made them sit in his own living room and asked them to sing. They were learning the Tyagaraja Kritis. They had not become masters. They were learning, they made mistakes. Wherever they made mistakes, Bhagwan corrected them. They went out of Talam, Bhagwan was playing Manjira and corrected them. Here was an exponent of Shastriya Sangeet, whom Bhagwan wouldn't even tolerate for 1 or 2 minutes. Here was his own students. They ran out of songs. They told Swami, this is all that we know. Swami told, start all over again. What do you do when you get up? You do sargam practice? Said, yes, Swami, do sargam practice now. And they did sargam practice in front of Swami. The difference, someone was singing from here, the children were singing from here. But that greatest exponent of Shastriya Sangeet, they are great masters. They are the devotees of Lord Goddess Saraswati. That greatest exponent of Shastriya Sangeet understood his mistake. He understood that if I have ego, ego has no place in Bhagwan's darbar. The day he realized that, Bhagwan gave another opportunity. And mind you, Bhagwan sat through his 1.5 hours rendition in another opportunity. And not only that, Swami kept asking him, sing more, and sing more.